Hello and welcome back to my channel. In today's video we are going to learn how to do this beautiful flowery design. So before we start with the video, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified about all my new videos. So let's begin with the base coat. I'm using Inkloth's breathable base as my base coat here. Apply the base coat and let it dry completely. Once your base coat is completely dried, I'm using this white base for my manicure. So I'll be using a bunch of watercolors today. So white is the best base for watercolor nail art. So apply one or two layers of white base and let it dry completely. After that, we are using this Chameleon top coat from Born Pretty. If you are interested in purchasing this one, I'll put the links in the description box. Also, I have a 10% discount code on Born Pretty store, so I'll put the links in the description box. Next is this watercolor polishes I got from AliExpress. It's a very cool polish to have. It's a lot of fun to, you know, create nail art using these watercolor ink polishes. So all I'm doing is just randomly placing those colors here and there, and then I'm going to let it dry completely. So now I'm kind of happy with the effect I created, and then I'm going to let it dry. After that, the next step is to apply the stamping design. So I'm using Cards Flowers 024 stamping plate from AliExpress. So I'll be using random flowers on each of my nails, and I'm also using Twinkle Tea stamping polish and this beautiful stamper from Born Pretty. So let's get start with the stamping. I'm using this image in my middle finger, and then I'll choose a random few other images for my other nails. So just pick up the image, and then I'm going to stamp it on top of that watercolor effect I created. So once you have transferred the image, clean up the excess around the cuticle area. I did not apply the liquid latex, so I have to clean it with acetone and a brush, and also I'm using a q-tip. So once you clean it, all you have to do is apply the top coat. Since I have used watercolors, I am using the special top coat from Picture Polish, so this will not spoil that watercolor effect that you have created. So once this is done, then this top coat itself is glossy, but if you want, you can then later go ahead with a glossy top coat, and that's it. We are done with the design. So this is how it looks. I hope you guys like this video. If yes, then don't forget to like, share, comment, all those good things, and I'll see you soon on my next video. Until then, take care. Bye bye.